I echo Bernadine and thank you all for coming. Hope that you enjoy this half as much as we have enjoyed preparing it to present to you this afternoon. It was initially prepared to perform about 3 weeks ago in Grand Haven, and The Days of Spring by Reinhold Becker. We'd like to begin our program this afternoon.
When the signs of spring can first be seen, and the sun comes out to melt the snows, when the trees display a touch of green, and amid the grass a flower it shows, when 'tis plain to see that all suddenly there is no more winter gloom to be. Hear it from the height, hear the valley ring. Oh, how wondrous bright are the days of spring. Oh, how wondrous bright are the days of spring. The days of spring. From hills around, when the tints of green have just begun, and the forest hears a joyful sound, fragrant breezes share in the meadows fair, and the heavenly blue is in the air.
The night from out the veil.
Gabriel Faré. The music will certainly set the mood for the swell of the tide, and the lyrics, the text, tells not only of those who make their living and their way of life by them, but as the title of the cradles intimates, it talks about their families, and especially the young members of those families back at home cared for by the mothers of the men at sea, The Cradles by Gabriel Faré. Statement I've often heard, as much Brahms as I've been privileged to sing and have a part in my lifetime. As I say, it's rather an irreverent phrase, I believe, but still it's very expressive in that he is the master of schmaltz. the very, very smooth, and I don't know another word that really describes it as well. A beautiful sound that he very often has in his music, and especially the songs, the choral settings, which most of us don't have the opportunity and privilege of hearing that often as the larger works of Brahms. In fact, something I just read lately, a description of his music, talks of the Academic Festival Overture and Symphony No. 4, but ends that list of five or six with his lullaby, which, as you'll notice, is the last setting that I hope to do for you today. First of all, though, Johannes Brahms from Opus No. 86, Alone in the Fields. After that, five folk songs that he has marvelously arranged, and again, which we would like to do as a unit, and bring out all the varied emotion that he has contained in these, in the music for these five folk songs, and of course in the text. Alone in the Fields, Johannes Brahms.
Thank you.
Two very contemporary composers in this group, only one of which we're singing of, Benjamin Britten, but both, well, these are love songs, ballads. At the River, of course, is an arrangement of a hymn tune, but both are very, very gifted in all, many kinds of composition, including opera, symphony. So at this time, the British, the folk song of the British Isles, by arranged by Benjamin Britten, The Sally Gardens.
Thank you. We'll gather by
In retrospect, I look back over this program just this afternoon, and most of the composers who are involved, and really it's quite a contemporary list until we get to this one as we begin the sacred portion of this concert. Heinrich Schütz lived at the turn of the 16th century. Otherwise, most of the composers, Strauss, Fauré, Copland, Britten, of course, are 20th century contemporary writers, and the others at least lived into this century. Even Brahms died in 1897. But Heinrich Schütz, as I said, is a different story. It's one of my favorite choral and sacred music composers. And we'd like to open this section of the program with the text of Psalm 29, verses 1 and 2, and chapter 66, verse 4. Bring to the Lord God, O all ye mighty men, by Heinrich Schütz.
The Lord God, bring to the Lord God, bring to the Lord God, O all ye mighty men. Bring to the Lord God, bring to the Lord God, glory and honor. Glory and honor.
Streaming. It was the next number in the book, and my procrastination won out, and I did do this one instead of the one that's on the program. In the manner of a chorale, Bach's Golden Sun Streaming.
To our poor world, darkened and more.
Kings, if it does not sound familiar to most of you I think will remember the melody as soon as you hear it start to be played. It's been one of my favorites for many of the years, one that you hum. However, in this particular arrangement, it's a little bit to a vocalist like running a marathon is to a runner because there are 8 verses. I never did quite dare to time it because I was afraid I wouldn't dare to include it in the program. The text, of course, is one of the Christians' favorite texts because it's the story of the Magi on their journey to the Babe of Bethlehem. March of the Kings, Old Provençal Melody.
Smile, the lone star smiled, Change to wine, then as thou is thou revealing, that solemn